Welcome to Art That Place and Praise. I'm glad to be back after quite a bit of absence. I'll be honest with you, with all the uncertainty happening in the world right now, I kind of hesitated on making this video. I wondered if it was appropriate to do so, and there are more pressing issues that are front and center in people's minds. But I realized that it would be good to create a sense of normalcy, and people cooped up in their homes feeling the burden of cabin fever because of social distancing just might find relief in a video or two. So I hope I can brighten up the atmosphere somehow with a whimsical painting using oil pastels by Sennelier. Sennelier is a French name, so you pronounce the brand as Sennelier, not Sennelier. Sennelier or whatever. It's my first time to use this medium, so with this unboxing and demo, I'll give you some feedback as well. Right off the bat, I can say that the packaging feels hefty. The crayons are individually housed in foam padding, as you can see here. I like how organized it looks, and the 48 color set I have here has a good representation of colors. Sennelier oil pastels have the same texture as lipstick. It's like playing with lipstick, actually. They're creamier and more delicate than Caran d'Ache color or Shiva oil paint sticks. Sennelier breaks off easily, so be careful. It doesn't look like it, but some of the pastels on my hand are broken in two. I'm just gripping it so well so the broken half doesn't slip off my hand. The pastels can be spread easily with your fingers or squished with a palette knife. Since these pastels are oil-based, you can blend the pigments using mineral spirits as well. I just don't have some right now, so I'm just using my fingers. That said, the painting process can be very messy, so it's best to keep a paper towel beside you when you're working. Take note, this is an oil-based medium. Drying time takes long. It's easy to blend the colors, but since the underpainting doesn't dry quick enough, it's also easy to create mud when layering. To avoid that, I wipe the tip of the pastel so I can layer a clean pigment each time. Just keep wiping the dirt or accumulated pigments on the tip of your pastel crayon so you don't create so much mess in your art. Now, I got the inspiration for this painting from a trip my family took late last year before this COVID thing struck. We visited a bird park in Malaysia and it was cool to see a lot of free roaming species through the lush landscape. Some of the birds just crisscrossed our path while we were strolling. One stork was even bold enough to chase my daughter and lightly tap her leg with a beak, as if he's trying to say, hello, hello. The Kuala Lumpur Bird Park is home to an estimated 3,000 birds belonging to 200 species. The unique ecosystem houses birds from different parts of the world, including ostriches and emus from Australia. We saw some rare parrots and critically endangered Moluccan cockatoo from Indonesia, a lot of yellow-billed storks, different kinds of owls, red lories. Now, those red lories, they're really so cute, and that's the best part of that entire park, at least for me it was. And there were flamingos too. I was just a bit disappointed I didn't find the toucans, which we loved when we first visited the aviary about 20 years ago. Our first visit was so memorable because a precocious toucan flew on our table and he kind of watched us dine, then sneakily ate my daughter's French fries. It was a pretty cool experience, which my now adult daughter still remembers to this day. Anyway, besides the lories, what I love the most in the KL Bird Park are the peacocks there are a lot of peacocks in the park, and that's what I'm showing you in this painting. The peacock's stunning green and blue plumage has an iridescent glow when hit by the sun. They spread their long train into a wide fan, as you all know. But what we don't know is that it rattles it 26 times a second, emitting low-frequency sounds that can be heard only by other peahens. They spread their feathers into a gorgeous arc, not just as part of a mating ritual to attract females. Apparently, these birds extend their tails in such a way to ward off predators too. That's because the spotted design of the feathers gives the impression of multiple eyes staring down at their enemies. When I learned about this, I thought how unique it was that the bird would show off its best features whenever it sensed danger. The peacock's tail is so heavy, since as you can probably imagine, so their first response to danger is not to run away. They just stay put. They look calm and unaffected. Well, in case you're wondering, peacocks can fly, but they can't go very far. When threatened by animals or humans, either they rush forward to scare you or they open their tails to make themselves look larger. And that's when you see their beautiful plumage, all the bright colors there. While I was brooding on this, I was reflecting about it, and I realized that there's much we can learn from peacocks. When we feel threatened by circumstances that are out of our control, our initial reaction is fear. Many of us take the flight response and act in irrational ways in an attempt to take back control of our situations. We don't stay put like the peacock. We don't look calm. We react with fear or anger or grief or irritation. Like this COVID pandemic example, it has driven many of us insanely mad. We are anything but still. We don't show off our best sides in the same way a peacock spreads its beauty as a reaction to insecurity and instability. We have to understand, sometimes God brings us to places of difficulty to teach us what stillness and calmness means. He's slowing us down so we may look to Him as the ultimate source of our security. Many of us find security in our careers, our money, our relationships, our education, or our health and possessions. We find answers to problems by scrolling endlessly on our devices, our cell phones, iPads. There's nothing wrong with that, but when these crutches break down, when the world is ground to a halt and economies are forced to slow down, what then? Uncertain times expose the inner weakness of our faith. It shows how little we depend on God and how little we acknowledge His sovereignty over our lives. We depend too much on ourselves and what we own, not on who gave us what we own. Viruses like the COVID make us fear because it's something we can't see nor predict nor control. But if we know God, if we have faith that's deep enough, if we know the Lord who holds our lives close to His heart and we believe His love will pull us through one crisis to the next, then we can be calm. You know, we hear stories of people who do just that during this pandemic. There are people who, like peacocks, show their beauty and best colors during a crisis. Let me give a shout out to the countless nurses, doctors, and frontline workers who give of themselves to take care of the helpless. They are driven by compassion and not just by sense of duty, and it's touching to see saints like them rise to the occasion. I especially want to thank the people who are taking care of the elderly shut-ins, because, you know, my mom, who lives on the opposite side of the globe from me, she is helplessly immobile, but kind people brought groceries to her door to make sure she has food at least for a month, and that bit of news brought tears to my eyes when I heard about it. So I'd like to thank these beautiful souls who show the best of humanity in these dire times. There are also stories of families in Ontario who decided to leave extra groceries in their front yard for anyone to freely get. And there were stories of owners of small restaurants. You know, a lot of the restaurants were forced to close down, right? But instead of letting their freezer food expire and spoil, they kind of generously share them to others without thinking twice about their lost profits. These people are acting like peacocks. They're showing their brightest and their prettiest colors in times of uncertainty. Trying times bring out the best or the worst in people, so the challenge is which side is coming out of you. Friends, thank you for joining me in another episode of Art That Place and Praise. I invite you to make the most of this time of social distancing to pray for the people who died and for those who are recovering. Let's pray for grieving families and for those who are working in the front lines, like the airport personnel, the hospital workers, or the people in the front end of food distribution, or those who are helping bring stability back into our world. These are their efforts. We appreciate them. Really, we do. And for all of you, my friends, take care, be safe, and see you again next time.